The Tata Group is an Indian multinational conglomerate holding company and holds its name in various sectors. It was founded by an Indian pioneer industrialist who is regarded as the father of Indian industries. He was the one who set up the Tata Industries when the whole of India was fighting for freedom. Yes, you guessed that right. I am talking about Jamshedji Tata. Let's see his accomplishments. Let's get on the track. Jamshedji Tata was born to Nusarwajni and Jeevanbhai Tata on 3 March 1839 in Navsari, a city in South Gujarat. He was born in a respectable but poor family of priests. His father, Nusarwanji, was the first businessman in the family. He started an export firm in Mumbai. Jamshedji was gifted with special mental arithmetic from a young age. Jamshedji Tata joined his father in Mumbai at the age of 14 and was enrolled at the Elphinstone College, completing his education as a Green Scholar. The Green Scholar is equivalent to a graduate. He was married to Hirabai Dabo while he was still a student. After graduating from the Elphinstone College in Bombay in 1858, he joined his father's export trading firm and mainly helped establish its strong branches in Japan, China, Europe, and the United States. Nusarwanji Tata wanted his son to be part of the opium business, so he sent Jamshedji Tata to China in order to learn about the business and give the details about the opium trade. However, when Tata traveled around China, he began to realize that trade in the cotton industry was booming and there was a chance of making a great profit. This influenced his business career, where he invested the most in the cotton mills throughout his lifetime. Tata worked in his father's company until he was 29. He founded a trading company in 1868 with 21,000 capital. He bought a bankrupt oil mill at Chinchpokali in 1869 and converted it into a cotton mill, and he renamed the mill as the Alexandra Mill. He sold the mill 2 years later for a profit. Tata wanted to set up more mills of cotton but at lower investment, so he chose the Nagpur, where he developed Empress Mill. At Nagpur, land was cheaper and resources were easily available. He set up the Dharmasi Mills at the Kurla in Bombay and later reselling it to buy the Advanced Mills in Ahmedabad. Through these many contributions, Jamshedji Tata advanced the textile and cotton industry in India. This was one of the many dreams Jamshedji had dreamt of. He was a great supporter of Swadeshi movement and even named one of the mills in Bombay as Swadeshi Mill. The iron and steel idea got sparked when Jamshedji went on a trip to Manchester to check out the new machines available for his textile mill. There, Jamshedji was inspired to set up iron and steel company when he attended a lecture by Thomas Carlyle in Manchester itself. He had his heart set on building a steel plant that would be compared with the best of its kind in the world. This was a gigantic task. Jamshedji found his path blocked at every other turn due to restrictions by the British policies. The torturous twists and turns incurred while he was working on his steel project would have defeated a lesser man, but Jamshedji remained steadfast in his determination to see the venture come to fruition. Along the way, he had to suffer the scorn of people such as Sir Frederick Upcott, the chief commander of the Great Indian Peninsular Railway, who promised to eat every pound of steel rail the Tata succeeded in making. But there was no record of where Sir Frederick was when the first ingot of steel rolled out of the plant's production line in 1912. Jamshedji had been dead 8 years by then, but his spirit, it was as much as the efforts of his son, Dorab, and cousin Adi Tata. The concept of the TISCO was introduced by Jamshedji but was executed by his son, J. Adi Tata. Jamshedji wanted India to climb out of the poverty. For this, he believed that its finest mind would have to be harnessed. Charity and handouts were not his way. So he established the G.N. Tata Endowment in 1892. This enabled Indian students, regardless of the caste, creed, to pursue higher studies in England. This beginning flowered into the Tata scholarships, which flourished to that extent that by 1924, 2 out of every 5 Indians coming to the elite Indian civil service were Tata scholars. The objective of creating the Indian Institute of Science came from the same source. But here, as with the steel plant, Jamshedji had to endure a long years of hard burn without getting any tangible recompense in the lifetime. Jamshedji pledged rupees 30 lakh from his personal fortune towards setting up the institute. Despite this and similar endorsements, it would take a further 12 years before the splendid Indian Institution of Science started functioning in Bangalore, now Bengaluru, in 1911. We must harness this water. We must turn into power. The idea struck Jamshedji Tata on a picnic by the Rahu River. Everyone knew that this was an electrifying concept. Jamshedji Tata resolved to provide pollution-free, clean power to Mumbai, a city that was choking on the fumes of the boilers of textile mills. He dreamt of and inspired the setting up of one of the first hydroelectric power plants in the Western Ghats, with a hydel dam that would harness the power of flowing water to create electricity. The hydroelectric power plant faced fewer hurdles, but that too could not be completed while Jamshedji was alive. Though he could not personally accomplish this task, Jamshedji's son Dorab and Ratan subsequently laid the foundation for affordable and clean power for the city of Bombay, now Mumbai. Out of the 4 major projects that Jamshedji had dreamt of, none had been completed while he was alive. But the 5th one, let's see. The 5th dream of Jamshedji Tata was to lay a luxurious hotel in Bombay. Jamshedji set his mind on building a luxurious hotel after being denied entry into one of the city's hotels for being an Indian. So he started diverting his mind towards this hotel project. The hotel turned out to be a bit fancier than that. By the time of its completion in 1903, it had cost rupees 4.21 crore. The hotel was soaked in luxury. It was the first building in Bombay to use electricity and the first hotel in the country to have American fans, German elevators, Turkish baths, English butlers, and whole lot of other innovative delights. This hotel was named Taj Hotel. The Taj Mahal Hotel was the first that was opened by the Tata Group. Out of all the ventures, the Taj Mahal Palace was the one that bore some fruit. So this was all about the ventures and life story of the founding of Tata and Jamshedji. He was a great visionary and the man who was a true patriot. While on a business trip to Germany in 1900, Tata became seriously ill. He died in a town in Germany on 19 May 1904. He was buried in a Parsi burial ground in Brookwood Cemetery, England.